Legends like Dr. Abdul Qadir Khan, the founding father of Pakistan's nuclear weapons program, don't die. Instead, their memories forever live on in the hearts of people that love them. At his jam-packed funeral that took place in Faisal Mosque on October 10, even Islamabad's thunderous skies were shedding tears. Dr. Khan's contributions towards giving Pakistan nuclear strength have strengthened Quaid-e-Azam's vision of Pakistan becoming an independent self-reliant state. The 226 million citizens of Pakistan remain forever grateful and indebted for Dr. Khan's selfless services and sacrifices. He will be remembered and celebrated not just as a prodigious atomic scientist, a nuclear physicist, and a talented metallurgist, but also as a national hero, a strategic doer, a genius mind, and an unapologetically selfless patriot who dedicated his every breath to defend and develop Pakistan's nuclear arsenal. Transforming Pakistan into a nuclear powerhouse was a collective effort where the most significant contribution was undoubtedly made by Dr. Khan. It was a combination of Dr. Khan's exceptional technical prowess, Zulfikar Ali Bhutto's savvy statesmanship, and the former chairman of the Pakistan Atomic Energy Commission, PAEC, Munir Ahmed Khan's trailblazing implementation methods. Pakistanis remain indebted to Dr. Khan for gifting us a sense of security, especially during a period of global instability where an unprecedented pandemic has taken over and nuclear brinkmanship brews like never before. The new great game in Afghanistan, the ongoing Indo-Pak hostilities, a restive occupied Kashmir, the reignited Indian-Chinese Galwan Valley skirmishes, the armed escalations triggered by the Quad and AUKUS, and a new Cold War fermenting between the US and China pose a serious threat to Pakistan, directly or indirectly. Strategic nuclear self-defense capabilities are more essential now than ever before, given the scheming and belligerent India whose Defense Minister Rajnath Singh hinted that New Delhi could revise its no-first use of nuclear weapons policy in order to provoke Beijing and Islamabad to amend their own no-first use mantras. The Biden administration's China containment strategy emboldens the Quad and AUKUS, incentivizing Delhi to beef up their naval nuclear capabilities, accelerating Islamabad's rapprochement with Beijing, where new regional nuclear power clusters are forming. India has already nuclearized the Indian Ocean region with its submarine-launched ballistic missiles, the K-4, K-15, the Agni-4, and the Agni-5, aimed at China, destabilizing the region's complex strategic geometry. Pakistan's strategic retort to Indian nuclear muscle flexing include the Babur 2 and Babur 3 missiles, offering Islamabad second strike capabilities. China's strategic response to India's missiles include their Dongfeng and Yingji missiles. Intensified US-Indian collaboration in sensitive defense technologies due to heated escalation with China over Taiwan swings the strategic nuclear power pendulum in South Asia, which, if left uncontrolled, could trigger a South Asian nuclear arms race teetering on a nuclear knife's edge. Dr. Khan couldn't have introduced his strategic nuclear deterrent competencies to Pakistan in a timelier manner, given Delhi's nuclear irresponsibility. 18 instances of nuclear material theft and sabotage, including more than 200 kilograms of uranium, were identified in India from 1994 to 2021, which ignited concerns of Indian-based nuclear terrorism. Such incidents were confirmed by the International Atomic Energy Agency's, IAEA, Incident and Trafficking Database. Pakistan decisively pays tribute to Dr. Khan's legacy by undertaking responsible nuclear stewardship and signing the IAEA Nuclear Safeguards Agreements. Pakistan's Nuclear Regulatory Authority fully allows the IAEA to conduct Integrated Regulatory Review Service audit inspections of its nuclear and radiation safety. The IAEA's chief, Rafael Mariano Grossi, confirmed Pakistan's seasoned reputation of peacefully promoting nuclear technology. IAEA's confidence in Islamabad was reaffirmed when they elected Pakistan to their Board of Governors during their 65th plenary conference. Pakistan globally leads by example. Regulators and nuclear technology users from Asia, Africa, and the Pacific will soon benefit from the PAEC's 50 years of experience in managing nuclear power and application projects, with recently concluded agreements between the IAEA and PAEC. Pakistan, to carry on honoring the lifelong legacy and spirit of Dr. Abdul Qadir Khan, is now the first international Muslim-majority nation that is operating civil nuclear power plants at Karachi's Kanup, and Punjab's Qasma 1 and 2 along with Shasnup in order to develop clean energy for mitigating the climate crisis. This not only protects our planet but responsibly secures our future generations.